In this class, girls, we will be dealing with the three chapters that you have for your annual syllabus of value education of class 10. Now remember, at the very beginning, we had dealt with a chapter at the crossroads. So first, we will be revising a little bit of things that are very important for every one of us to remember and that we really face in life, girls, isn't it? We at times do really, really feel that we are at the crossroads of life where we cannot take a decision on our own, where we get very confused and puzzled of what to do and which path to follow so that we have success in our life in the future. So for each and every one of us, girls, it's not only for you students, but for us too, that we too at times feel that we are standing at the crossroads in life. And it is very necessary to overcome that. Unless and until you get focused in how to deal with the crossroads in life, girls, you can never overcome those obstacles and then move on, isn't it? If you get stuck right at that moment, then it really becomes very much impossible to move on in life. Depression, fatigueness, every negative aspect of life just grinds you down to the ground. So this is really, really important, girls, that how can we overcome the crossroads in our life? Now, first that we should know of is, what does crossroads in life mean? I have said it in my previous class also, but in details, but here we are just going to revise the important questions or the important factors that are in this chapter. Now, what does crossroads in life mean? The noun crossroads is great for describing a point in your life when you have to make an important decision, like, for example, girls, when you need to choose whether you wish to attend college or do some other vernacular courses or do something else that really relates to your passion and your love of what you actually want to do in life. The second important question that comes, girls, is that what does it mean to be at crossroads? Now, it means more than you realize. Occasionally, we get to a point in our lives where we see the path diverging in front of us. We at times get utterly confused which path to follow. Because future, we never know, girls, what is in hold of our future. We do not know that. So it becomes very difficult for us to know that which is important for us. Sometimes it becomes more dramatic than we find ourselves at a closer crossroad. Parting ways, evident choices, decisions that cannot coexist. Now, why do crossroads make us feel scared? What is there to be scared about, crossroad girls? There are two paths, there are different paths before us, you can go for any one. Then why do we get scared when we cannot take any decision when we stand at a crossroad? Crossroads generally make us feel scared, girls, because we feel we are not sure of what we are supposed to do. We see crossroads as difficult because we know that many paths have bright outlooks, but may contain one or two bad paths. The question is, how bad are the bad paths? And how likely are we to venture down those if we cannot see what lies beyond it? Okay. So, there is where we get scared, girls, because we really, what I said before is that we do not know what our future is. We are completely uncertain about our future. So it becomes very difficult that if I go in the wrong way or choose the wrong path, how far will I be able to come back and really achieve? Because certain bad paths may really be very, very bad for you. Because we cannot see what lies beyond it. Now, what are the three things to do when you hit a crossroad, girl? This is very important, girls. There are two ways to go when you hit that crossroad in your life. There is a bad way when you sought or give up. And there is really, really the hard way when you fight back. And how to make a decision at a crossroad? Make the decision based on what you really want in life, girls. Don't make it based on what's easiest in the moment or what has the least risk or even what other people expect of you. Instead, you do what is right for you and let the consequences follow, girls. Now, how will you get to know, or what are the signs that you can realize that you are at a crossroad? Only then can you overcome that, when you realize, yes, I am at a crossroad. You feel tired all the time. Your emotions are all over the place. You cannot make decisions. You don't feel passionate about life. You don't trust your judgment. There feels like something is missing in your life. Only then can you understand or realize that you are at a crossroad, and then you can really work out on that, girls. The second important chapter in your syllabus is, girls, what is creative leadership? Now, leadership is the capacity of a company's management to set and achieve challenging goals, take fast and decisive action when needed, outperform the competition, and inspire others to perform at the highest level they can. Now, this is what leadership is. You outperform the competition, and not only for yourself, you can also inspire others to perform at the highest level they can. And what do you need to really become a creative leader, girls? That is, your self-development should be very high. Your team development should be good. Strategic thinking and acting, that is a skill that you should really possess. And your innovation skill. And these are the leadership skills I am speaking about. Do not get confused with the characteristics of a good leader, girls. That is integrity, communication, self-awareness, gratitude, learning agility, influence, and empathy. These are the characteristics. First, I have spoken about leadership skills, and these are the characteristics of a good leader. Then comes, I'll be giving you certain examples of strong leadership skills. Leading a project or task in school, this can be any level of school, organizing a study camp or a study group, spotting a problem and finding a solution, sports leadership experience, volunteer leadership. These are the examples of strong leadership skills. Another very important question, girls, is that what are leadership strengths? Simply put, leadership strengths are traits and qualities that serve leaders well, helping them to more effectively lead, manage, and motivate their followers. Leadership strengths are those strengths that are not only helpful to have, but nearly vital to have if you want to be an effective leader. So leadership skills are different from leadership strengths, and that is different from the characteristics of a good leader. When you write the answers, be very careful that you do not write the same thing in each and every question. That is different, girls. Now, why is creativity important in leadership? This you should know very well, girls. Why is creativity important in leadership? Creativity is one of the most important qualities of a modern leader. Creative leaders have the ability to look at things in new ways and solve problems by seeing things others don't stop. That is why creativity is very, very important in leadership. You should have a vision. Right, girls? You can see things that others don't. Or you should have the capability that others don't get to stop you. And how can you improve creativity, girls? There are 9 ways that you can dramatically improve your creativity. Learn through collaboration. Do something you love. Find inspiration from others. Set the right mood. Ask for advice or feedback. This is how you can really improve your creativity, girls. Right? So do start to culture all these things to be a good creative leader. And the third chapter, girls, that is very important, as you all will be sitting for your madhyamik exams just a few months later, and many students are really, really confused which career or which stream to take up as a career. So here you need this chapter very honestly. Now, I'll tell you something. What do you want to be in future? A teacher randomly asked a senior one student of a school in Remera, Gasabo district in Kigali city. "I want to become a doctor like my father," the student replies. And on the discussion continues. What is clear from this interaction, girls, is that children have different dreams that they cannot logically explain why they want to take that path or how to get there. And that is when the concept of career guidance comes in. So, isn't it really necessary that to know the importance of career guidance? Now, according to an online source, girls, career guidance is a development process that facilitates the acquisition of attitudes, skills, and knowledge to help students better understand while exploring viable education and career options that eventually result into making informed decisions with developed plans to improve. And why do that is the importance of career guidance. And why do the students need this? The students need career guidance and counseling in order to achieve optimum gains in their varied situations. The programs will help the students in secondary schools to see a variety of available academic options that would help them through their preferred learning styles and be helped to find how to develop plans to reach their educational and occupational goals. That is why you really, really need to have a career guidance, girls, because at your stage, we too were very confused of which stream to take up. We too had the parents' pressure on us what to choose, as most of our parents really decided our careers for us. But that shouldn't be, because you know your passions, you know your likings, you know your skills, you know where to do what. In the 21st century, if a student says, "Ma'am, I'm utterly confused," listening to that seems a very absurd thing. You should really know your skills and how to employ them in the field that will lead you to success, girls. So that is very important. Yes, you might get confused. You can ask things that you can not only to your parents, girls, your friends also at times know you best, more than you at times. So you can ask them that, how do I improve? There's no harm in asking, girls. There's no harm in letting yourself flow with the time and ask your friend that, what will be good of me? What can I do to increase my capability? How do I get to that? These are really, really very, very basic questions that you can really take the help of your parents, your friends. If you have a proper guide, girls, nothing can be better than that, because sometimes really we do get confused. If you get a good marks in a particular subject, you think I'm really good at it. No, it might at times not click there. So know your likings, know what you love to do, know what is your passion, and then, girls, only then, girls, will you be able to prosper in your career. So these are the three important, very, very important chapters, girls, for your value education. And truly speaking, if you really go through it, it will be a great help to you all, girls, to know that how to really frame your life in a very, very positive way. Okay? Do go through the notes, do go through the videos, girls. Do not just keep it, "Oh, it's a value education chapter, what is there?" No, that is also the most important thing in life rather now. So, thank you and goodbye.